Can you tell me who we're headed?
No, I can't. In fact, we're gonna have to cover your eyes shortly.
When I was a kid, we had a cereal made of uni, and I never saw an urchin until I was 2 years out of high school. A friend of mine, a mutual friend, was an urchin diver. I just saw his hands, which were covered in lumps and bumps from the urchin spines. And that was my first exposure of any sort to urchin.
Once upon a time, it was designated for the garden. That's the part you can't film, don't show that.
I enjoy being under the water, the total weightlessness and euphoria that really you can experience nowhere else but, you know, maybe outer space. I have a really good idea of where the urchins are going to be. Most of the time I know where they're going to be, where I need to harvest, and where the best quality is going to be. Our uni ends up all across the world. There's a paste that's made up that ends up in Italy. There is processed uni that ends up in Japan or China or Korea or other Asian countries. Whole urchins end up here in the continental U.S. at high-end sushi restaurants. Domestically, people are really acquiring a taste for sushi and uni. There's nothing that I've tasted that tastes like urchins. Some urchin roe is bitter, some is sweet, but for some it is an acquired taste. My job is sometimes the easiest job in the world, and sometimes my job is the most difficult job in the world as far as danger, in that we fish during the winter time, we fish during really cold weather, during really windy weather. But I enjoy diving tremendously. There's nowhere else that I can think of you're gonna escape, you know, cell phones and noise and just everyday commotion other than, you know, underwater or, you know, maybe up on a mountain somewhere.